So you run a local business and you hear all of these tips online for how to grow your company. Optimizing your Google local listings. Are you supposed to get on TikTok? Are you supposed to do Instagram? What are the actual best strategies to generate leads for your local business? Stick around. Now, I've talked in the past about how I never do business with local companies or small companies anymore because honestly, you guys can't afford a good marketer. A lot of small businesses, they have tiny budgets, or really the owners are fighting over every dollar and it's hard for them to spend money or invest money in marketing. So what I want to talk about today are some awesome strategies that you can use for your local business or your small business to generate leads. And more importantly, the way to think about lead generation so that you don't run in a million different directions. And hopefully you can use that to get out of the small business territory and into the real business territory. The number one thing to think about when you're trying to find a lead generation strategy for your business is not, what have I heard about this week and how can I use that to generate leads for my business? Meaning, you're not gonna watch a Gary Vee video talking about TikTok and then immediately think, oh, maybe I need TikTok for my business. Instead, you should think about this question. Where are my customers right now? Meaning, if you're a grocery store and your customers are still using the newspaper, then maybe advertising in the newspaper is the best option. Are most of your customers walk-ins off the street? If they are coming off the street, then optimizing that and adding more signage outside or changing your outdoor signage might be the best option, not TikTok, not Twitter. Or are they coming through Yelp? And in that case, it might be worth investing in the sketchy Yelp advertising from the people that keep calling you and hassling you constantly. This video is brought to you by Uplead. Uplead is a B2B lead generation tool that gives you access to millions of contacts worldwide. Unlike other tools on the market, Uplead offers real-time email verification, so you can be sure you're getting high-quality, accurate information. Try it out today and get 25 free leads by entering partner code X27. Just go to uplead.com today and start your free trial, no credit card required, and be sure to enter the partner code X27 for 25 free leads. But what if you don't know? Here is how I would find how customers find your business. The key is to go to Google, everyone loves it, and search what your customers would search to find your business. So I'm gonna actually use three real life examples, and for each one of these, three different types of businesses, I'll go through and give recommendations on how they can improve, and hopefully you can learn from them. The first example I wanna talk about is Skillman Walk in Dallas. This is a Chinese restaurant in Dallas, Texas. So get in the mind, let's pretend that you own Skillman Walk. Get in the mind of your customer. They want Chinese food in Dallas. Where are they gonna go? They're either going to look on their phone or they're going to search on Google, Chinese food, Dallas, Texas. The number one thing that comes up is Google Local, Google Maps, and you see Skillman Walk is not on here. So number one, get on these Google Local listings, and there's plenty of videos online about how to rank here. And this would be our number one priority, is getting up on this thing, adding more reviews and photos, making the name optimized, et cetera, getting up here. Number two is this Dallas Eater article, 11 essential DFW Chinese restaurants. You want to reach out to these guys and try your hardest, pay if you have to, call them, chase down Amy McCarthy, her name is right here, and try to get Skillman Walk on this list. Simple as that, right? So we're going where our customers are. She's in Dallas, she's local. I'm sure you reach out, you give her a gift or something, maybe you can get an Eater article, but that would be the second priority. So number one would be the Google Local listing. Number two would be trying to get on this Eater article. And number three and four and five and six is adding yourself to all of these directories. So for instance, Yelp, you can pay to be on. TripAdvisor, you can pay or add yourself for free. The D Magazine directory, I don't know much about this, but I'm assuming this is pay to play as well. So you can pay to be on this one, or at least pay to be ranked higher. So negotiate and spend a little cash, grease a couple palms. And the trick is you search what your customer is looking for. So Chinese food, Dallas, Texas. And then you wanna rank everywhere the customer is looking. The easiest way to do that is to get on these articles that already exist. And getting on these articles will help you. And this is before SEO, right? I'm not saying hire an SEO consultant and try to become like the Walk Chinese, which is number one on Google, but really it's number one, two, three, four, five behind all of these other directories. So you can either spend thousands of dollars with an SEO consultant to get to number six on Google, or get on the Eater article, which is number one, or even get on Yelp and pay Yelp, and then you'll be number two at least. Simple as that. So that's Chinese restaurants. Now, the second one is a cleaning service, Two Maids, Birmingham, Alabama. So first of all, I'm Alex Berman, so I love Birmingham, just for the name. That's my city. I've only been there once. It was a terribly racist town. I do not recommend it. All right, Birmingham, Alabama. So what I would search for is cleaning services, Birmingham. And again, what you get is Google local listings. These actually seem easier to compete on. This one only has 7 reviews and it's right at the top. Two Maids and a Mop, this would be your biggest competitor here. 164 reviews, I wouldn't even really worry about them, but you could rank this pretty easy. And you can see here, Two Maids and a Mop is paying for SEO. They've jumped Yelp, but Yelp is right here. Maids.com is another cleaning company that's paying for SEO. However, don't worry about that. Almost all of these business types have directories that you can list in either for free or for a small fee. And I would do all of that first. So Yelp, make sure you're on Yelp. Make sure you're on care.com. Here you go, list yourself on care.com. List yourself on Angie's List, the cleaning authority, Thumbtack, right? And notice some of these sites are the same that I was recommending for the Chinese restaurants, like Yelp. However, did I mention Thumbtack when I was talking about the Chinese restaurants? Did I mention Angie's List? No. Did I know anything about these? Sort of, but I found them by searching what your customers would search online and then optimizing that way. So this is how you find where your leads are going already, and then you can improve from there. So let's do one more, and that is Men's Fashion in Winston-Salem. This is a small retail store in Winston-Salem. They actually have 2 locations in Greensboro and Winston-Salem.
Hey, we're giving away the email 10K course to one of our lucky subscribers for free. To win, all you have to do is subscribe to the YouTube channel. We have some crazy cold email and business content on here. Subscribe to the mailing list, which you can do by going to email10k.com/checklist and getting our free cold email optimization checklist. Like this video and share this video, and fill out the attached Google form. Your chances multiply every single time you share one of our videos, and the winner is going to be announced at the end of this month. So go complete those steps for a chance to win our $1,000 course, Email 10K. You can get that for free.
So to find Men's Fashion, I would search men's suit Winston-Salem. You can see immediately there's a lot of competition here. Men's Warehouse actually has an ad. I didn't see an ad for any of the other local markets, right? Men's Warehouse is running an ad for men's suits Winston-Salem. Where are you, Skillman Walk in Dallas? No other Chinese restaurant was running an ad. And the same goes for the cleaning company. You can jump your competitors just by running an ad on Google Local. This is the only thing I would focus on. Number one, I didn't even know this was possible. I'm glad that I see it here. Although Men's Warehouse is listed twice, you can see Men's Fashion already is doing pretty good. They have 105 reviews in Google Local, and they're not out competing Men's Warehouse, but they do have a higher review, which is great. They're not even beating Runway Menswear. I would invest in some advertising if I was Men's Fashion. But then also, Yelp, Men's Warehouse is number 2, Joseph A. Bank, Stores, Men's Fashion. So Men's Fashion is actually doing pretty good in terms of optimizing. Yellow Pages, Reddit, here we go, okay. Recommendations for affordable men's suits in the area posted 10 months ago. If I was in Men's Fashion, I would repost this. Similar question now, and then make sure that Men's Fashion was at the top of this. Men's Fashion is number 21 on Yellow Pages. I would try to get it to number 1, either by buying an ad or getting it up here. But the main thing I would work on if I was Men's Fashion, oh, same with Yelp. Men's Fashion is not even on the first page. So I would try to get to number 1 on Yelp as well, either by paying there. So a lot of these local businesses, it turns out Yelp is huge, but it's not the only thing. And actually for a lot of them, I would recommend spending money on these Google Local ads because they pop up before Yelp. And those are the awesome lead gen strategies for local businesses. But more importantly, I have shared with you a framework for how to think about lead gen strategies so you're not chasing tactic to tactic to tactic. You're not just running after what each guru is teaching you. If you want more help with this kind of thing, we do business coaching over at 220coaching.com. And we also make business videos 3 times a week, all about sales, marketing, and growing your company. So subscribe for more videos like this. Like this video to encourage this type of content and leave a comment down below. Did you find this interesting? Did you learn anything? Let's get a conversation going. Thanks for watching. I'm Alex Berman.